बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम रब्बी इशराहली सदरी व यस्सिरली अमरी वहलुल उक़दता मिन लिसानी यफ़क़हू क़ौली। आई एम डॉक्टर अहमद सईद, प्रोफेसर ऑफ फोरेंसिक मेडिसिन। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर नाउडेज डिस्कसिंग पर्सनल आइडेंटिटी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस हाउ टू एस्टीमेट द एज, एज एस्टिमेशन। द एज स्पैन begins with conception within the womb and after birth passing through different stages ends with death. The age span has three clear phases, two of activity and one of rest, the static phase being in the middle. Three phases are: first, progressive phase; second is static phase; third is retrogressive phase. Progressive phase, it is the first and biologically active period showing developments in the human body. Every part of the body increases in size. It has two distinct stages: an intrauterine stage followed by an extrauterine stage. Starting from birth to attainment of about 25 years. Second is static phase. It is second and biological inactive period from 25 years to about 40 years, during which there is no change in the body. Then is retrogressive phase. It is a third and again biologically active period from 40 to 42 years, showing degenerative changes in almost every part of the body. Biological changes in the proliferative phase are increase in the size of every part, length and weight of a person, and other diverse changes in the complexity of the body. These changes corresponded to an established chronology having relation with time. Advantage is taken of this record of events in order of time. Age can be estimated with degree of reasonable accuracy. Afterwards, in the retrogressive phase, changes in most parts of the body do occur, but their appearance is erratic and age estimation is only an approximation. Parameters of age determination in living. Number one is height and weight. Number two is graying of the hair. It starts usually in 35 years. Wrinkling on the face. It appears in about after 40 years. Order of appearance is forehead, around the eyes, nasolabial folds. Arcus senilis, it appears after 50 years. This arcus senilis is white circumferential opacity at the limbus due to limbus of the eye due to lipid deposition. Cataract usually appears in 60 years, and dental data is also helpful in the age estimation. Presence and eruption of teeth, it helps in age estimation, and also the wear and tear of the teeth. It also helps in age determination. temporary teeth are 20 in number, while permanent teeth are 32 in number. Secondary sex characteristics. Stage of development of secondary sex characteristics in female are telarche. It is up to about 10 to 11 years. Development of the breast starts, then no pubic hair, no menstruation. Second stage is bilharzi. When the age of the age is more than 12 years. In this there is development of the breast, appearance of the pubic and axillary hair, and no menstruation. Then third is menarche, when age is more than 13 years. In this there is further development of the breast and appearance of the pubic and axillary hair, and menstruation starts. Radiologically, the appearance of the ossification centers, fusion of the epiphyses and closure of the sutures, they help in determination of the age. Parameters in the dead, age estimation is done in dead with help of the bones. Determination of the age by bones or teeth. Determination from the size of long bones. Age can be determined by size of the long bones. Up to the time when growth ceases, that is about 25 years, length of the individual bones indicate development stage. The period covered extends from 5th fetal month to near adulthood. We find the age from size of the long bones, especially femur, plotted in graphic method. Determination from ossification center and epiphyseal union. This sign is helpful until ossification is completed. Scargrams are taken for determination the extent of the ossification and union of the epiphyses of the bone. Variations are due to climate, diet, heredity, etc. X-ray or scargrams of main joints are taken from both sides, usually elbow and wrist joints. If all epiphyses are fused, age may be taken above 25 years. Then epiphyseal union. Epiphyseal union completes at the age of in elbow in 14 to 50 years in males, wrist 60 to 70 years in males, shoulder 18 to 19 years in male, iliac crest, epiphyseal union occurs in 20 to 25 years in males, in clavicle, medial end, epiphyseal union occurs in 22 to 23 years in the males. For females, it is 2 years less than the males, that is minus 2 years from the above data. Ossification center appearance, intrauterine. From ossification center from the appearance of the ossification center, we can determine age, especially in the intrauterine life. At the 5th month of gestation, calcaneus foot, that is whole hand, is cartilaginous during the intrauterine life. at the 6 months of gestation, lower two segments of the sternum. They are helpful in they unite. At 7th month of the gestation, there is appearance of the ossification center in the talus of the foot. At the 8th month of the gestation, upper two segments of the sternum, there is appearance of the ossification centers. In the 9th month of gestation, cuboid of the foot, there is appearance of this ossification center in this. Sorry. After birth, from 6 to 12 months, distal end of femur, proximal tibia, head of humerus, capitate, hamate, head of femur, distal tibia and distal fibula, they appear in order. From 12 to 24 months, head of humerus, head of tibia, head of first four metacarpals, lower end of the radius center, they appear. And in the third year, center for patella, it ossification center for patella appears. In the fourth year, upper end of the fibula, greater trochanter of the femur, they appear. In the first year, greater tubercle of the humerus, greater tubercle fuses with the head of the humerus. Eruption of the teeth and calcification of the root. The milk teeth, eruption of these teeth is subject to greater variation. For example, at 1 year age, a few infants may have no teeth and a few have 12 teeth or more. Total 20, they are milk teeth, 4 incisors, 2 canines, 4 molars in each jaw. In 6 to 8 months, lower central incisors appear. 7 to 9 months, upper central and lateral incisors appear. 12 to 14 months, first molars, they appear. And 70 to 18 months, canines, they appear. 20 to 30 months, second molars, they appear. So, key is that from 6 to 12 months, incisors appear. 12 to 15 months, first molar. 15 to 20 months, canines. 20 to 30 months, second molar, they appear. Permanent teeth, they are 32 in number, 4 incisors, 2 canines, 4 premolars, 6 molars in each jaw. 6 to 8 years, central incisor and first molar appear. In 7 to 9 years, lateral incisors appear. 9 to 12 years, first and second premolar appear. 11 to 12 years, canines, they appear. From 12 to 14 years, second molar appear. And from 70 to 25 years, third molar appear. So, key is 6 years, first molar appears. 7 years central incisors, 8 years lateral incisors, 9 years first premolar appear, and 10 years second premolar they erupt, 11 years canines erupt, and 12 to 14 years second molar appear, and 17 to 15 years third molar. Then is the vertebral ossification and atrophic changes. In youth, the upper and lower surfaces of the bodies of the vertebrae bear radial markings which are pronounced at the age of 10 years. Thereafter, they begin to fade and disappear by the age of 30 years. The lipping of the bone occur at the age of 40 years and is generally seen in human vertebrae and joint of extremities. The osteophytic outgrowth from anterior and lateral margins of intervertebral discs rarely become prominent before 40 years. Disc itself undergoes atrophic changes by 45 to 50 years. Suture closure. In Pakistan, different cranial vault sutures are going to be closed at as under. Sagittal sutures, they close at the age of 30 to 35 years. Coronal sutures, they close at the age of 30 to 40 years. Lambdoid suture, they close at the age of 45 to 50 years. While in West, the ages of suture closures are different due to environment, dietary habits, and inheritance. Then is transformation of pubic symphysis. Transformation of pubic symphysis is also helpful in determination of the age. Surface of the pubic symphysis is divided into three components, component 1, 2, and 3, by a vertical groove into dorsal and ventral halves. Each component has allotted scores ranging from 0 to 5. A particular score give us the clue of particular age pertaining to male or female gender. There is development sequence from component 1 to component 3. Component 1, dorsal plateau, to dorsal demyphase, and component 2, ventral rampart, ventral demyphase. Component 3, symphysial rim or symphysial surface. Changes of the scapula, that is also helpful in age determination. So age determination, age can be determined by scapula by following parameters. Appearance of the ossification center in scapula, it ossifies to form two primary and seven secondary centers. Primary center first for the body of scapula by 8th week of intrauterine life, it appears, and primary center second for coracoid process by the first year of the life. Two secondary centers for acromial cartilage appear at puberty and fuse soon. It joins with the spine at the age of 20 years. The two secondary centers appear for coracoid at puberty and fuse at 40 to 70 years. One secondary center for vertebral border appears at the age of 70 years and fuses at the age of 20 years. One secondary center for inferior angle appears by 16 years of age and fuses at the age of 20 years. One secondary center for glenoid cavity appears at puberty and fuses at 20 years of age. Union is completed by the age of 20 years. Then is age changes in the mandible. These age changes in the ramus, mental foramen, and condyles, they are given in this table, and you can study it from this table. The third is atrophic process after maturity. Surface vascularity below 25 years visible with the naked eye examination. Deep vascularity in 25 to 30 years visible with transillumination. Atrophic spots begin at 45 years of the age. So age changes in the mandible. It should be considered in relationship to the shape of the bones and as a whole and various parts. That is the ramus, condyle and mental foramen. Intrauterine age estimation. Age estimation up to 5th month of the gestation. Number of the somites, it is determined from number of the somites. So 59 plus number of the somites divided by 3 is age in days. Second is the intrauterine age estimation is the Hess's rule. It narrates a sequence of the months of gestation, give length of the fetus in centimeters up to 5th month. Length of the fetus in centimeters is equal to square of the months of the gestation afterwards. Third is the anatomical features. In first month, limb buds are present. Second month, head with ears and hands. Third month, placenta formed, appearance of the nail. Four months, there is sex determination, hair and head. Hair on the head appear. Then is age estimation after 5 months. It is done by Hess's rule. Length of the fetus in centimeter divided by 5 gives the number of the months of gestation. Centers of the second is the center of the ossification. From centers of ossification we can determine the gestational age, intrauterine age. Then at the 5th month, calcaneus head that appears. At 6 months, lower segment of the sternum, center for lower segment of the sternum appear. At 7th month, talus. 8 months, upper 2 segments of the sternum appear. 9 months, cuboid ossification center appears. Weight of the fetus can also indicate the age of the fetus. 5th month weight is 350 to 450 grams. At 6 months 350 plus 350 it is 700 grams. 7th month 700 plus 350 1050 grams. At 8 months 1050 plus 350 1400 grams. And 9th month 400 into 2 is 2800 grams. So this is the table which shows the number of the somites and the age in days. This table shows the length, weight and morphological feature of the fetus. You can see it from the table, these features. Length of the bones. After 5 months, length of the femur is taken to assess the fetal length. In later stages, length of the multiple long bones is taken for assessment of the age of the fetus.